Previously on The Apprentice, I invited 16 of America's best and brightest entrepreneurs to New York City for a 13-week job interview.
Well, I want to welcome all of you here to Martha Stewart Living Omnimedia. First, I'd like to introduce you to Charles Koppelman and Alexa Stewart. They are going to accompany you on all of your tasks.
The candidates divided into two teams based on their careers. Half considered themselves creative and named their team Matchstick. The other half were corporate and called themselves Primarius.
I say we kick some creative ass! Come on!
Then they were given their first task.
The task was to make a modern adaptation of an old fairy tale.
We're doing a really unique form of Jack and the Beanstalk.
The idea that I'm proposing is Hansel and Gretel. It's all about running away.
That would be a very dark story.
I have a very difficult time the way things are going right now.
Shut up right now and listen so we can get through this.
Dawn really can't do the work with a room full of screaming people.
Dawn, at this point, I'm the project manager.
Tell me what to do, and I'm going to do it. Do you want to pick out my wardrobe today, too?
You should stop engaging me, because I'm going to shower now.
I'm trying to make
If you would like to join me in the bathroom, you may, but I'm going to be naked.
Book's done, but now it's up to the children.
All right, everybody, all at once. Who liked it? Okay.
So how did they do?
The winner of this first task is Primarius.
Matchstick, I'll see you in the conference room, and one of you will be asked to go home. Matchstick, you considered yourselves to be the creative team. Dawn, you actually teach writing, so did you write the book?
No, it was Jeff.
I don't like the story.
Dawn never signed on to the project, and
That's
so she
true.
Was a drag.
You came in and you said,
editing.
I have to get something to eat.
I did not.
Don't lie.
Everything that Martha Stewart did not like about this project was only decided by solely you.
I agree.
You.
Jeff, you just didn't connect. And the message was really off. And it was your message. So, Jeffrey, you just don't fit in. Goodbye. 15 candidates remain. Who will ultimately be the apprentice?
Take strong people on our team into the boardroom with you if there's a chance you could knock them out? Or would you be too worried that you would get knocked out if you did that? I mean, that's the big risk.
I think you need to think for now. There's no tomorrow.
I walked in the room and just with like the greatest, most obnoxious bravado that I could muster, I just let loose on everybody.
What the hell? I'll dish it. So, you know what I said? I'm like, you know, Martha, everything that you found repugnant and unacceptable for children in this book was a tyrannical, undebatable executive decision made by Jeff.
I have a message to Matchstick, and I have a message to Primarius, do not come after me in the conference room.
What I did was I took the scythe, and the mighty oak stood before me, and I picked the scythe up, and I cut it at the ankles, and it fell like a great timber. Later, biatch!
I don't know what my reaction is.
I think Jim is completely unpredictable. I think he's unstable.
and I think that he'll whip whatever he needs to out when he needs it.
The king is dead. Long live the king!
Jim's tactic is very straightforward, ruthlessness. He cares about no one. He's not here to make friends. He's not here to learn. He's here to accomplish one thing, and that's to slit the throats of everyone else.
I just sent a man home,
and I basically did it myself. Okay. I'm the architect of this, yeah. So.
No, you're not.
All right.
You're not the architect. He could have done things differently, you know?
I see it differently. And if I had told the truth, maybe somebody else would have went home instead of Jeff.
Smart.
You see it the way you see it, and I see it the way I see it.
They don't even get it yet. This is not about being nice or being mean, you freaking idiot. You know what? I could possibly be the most cunning person on this team, and all I want to do is succeed in business, but you're good, and you really don't care as much about that, so why don't you get my back? We're friends.
Hi, it's Julia from Martha's office.
Martha's really busy this morning, but she asked that you all meet in front of the video screen in the loft at 9 a.m. Don't be late. Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm at one of my very favorite wholesale florists, looking for new ideas for our flower business, marthasflowers.com. Do you know the names of all these flowers?
Uh-oh.
Delphinium, allium, dahlias, even a wonderful chartreuse euphorbia. I hope you do know the names of all these flowers, because your next task is challenging. Each team is going to be given its own retail space, and you're going to set up a flower business. The team that earns the most revenues is the team that's going to win. Let's see how you do, and good luck.
I think Chuck has got the best ability to go out and pick the flowers or pick the arrangements.
When Martha told us that we were having a floral shop, I was very excited because I've done freelance flower work for many years. I certainly am comfortable with the flower market and some of the costing stuff. I can manage this product. I think that our concentration as far as a product needs to be, a simple spring bloom. I don't think that we should be arranging flowers.
I agree.
I don't think that we should be doing anything that absorbs our time.
We immediately started realizing that what we needed to do is get a product before we knew how to sell it. So Chuck and I and David went down to the wholesale flower market district. How do you feel about just sticking with one variety? Simple?
I'm thinking very much that that's going to be the case.
And what do you think about if it were tulips? Spring tulips.
Look at the lilacs. Look at the lilacs.
Mm. I'm getting my shipments in tomorrow. I got to see what they're sending me out of Holland.
Okay. Fresh from Holland.
Fresh from Holland.
Hello, marketing plan. We decided that we were going to zero in on this one florist who could get us 2,000 tulips flown in fresh from Holland and have them ready by 6:30 in the morning. And of course, we don't open till 8, so that gives us plenty of time for packaging.
We're going to sell fresh bundled tulips. Very simple, very, very, very simple.
And don't spend your money on all the flowers yet. This is the marketing plan that I'm proposing. We need 3 prototypes that we're going to sell to hotels or to whomever.
And have made
hotels in the city. Those things are kind of nailed down.
No.
Stop.
Give me the phone. I know what your idea is. Let me talk. They're going to deal better with me.
No.
Wait. I cannot. Jimbo, listen to me.
No.
I promise.
I want to talk it.
But no one wants to talk to you because you're insane.
They do.
I promise.
Talk.
No, they don't. I promise I'll get your idea. Okay. Just tell me what you're proposing, and I'm going to tell you what we're proposing.
No, tell them what we're proposing.
Jim wanted to call to scream to Chuck his amazing ideas and put Chuck on a different path, and I just was like, just let him do what he has to do. And Jim and I began to fight like 3-year-olds.
Let me talk to him.
They're
very, very simple.
And we were not communicating, and I was miserable.
I need to say something to Chuck about it first.
No, you don't. Stop controlling every process. Just let me finish it. I'm a smart person.
Listen to me. Bethany.
There is seriously something wrong with our team. We are screaming and fighting, and nobody is able to back down. Nobody can come to a consensus. We're a total mess. We can't get anything done.
I'm not happy.
It's okay. We're going to get through this. We're going to get through it.
Once you have your great idea, to be able to lead a team to create a successful business is very important.
I have some more drawings you can approve also for the new set. This is the rolling set table. Okay.